Thank you. Thank you, Matteo. Fabrizio is speaking, and thank you, Matteo, Jose, for this kind introduction, and thank you everyone for attending this webinar, and in such a difficult situation. And so I really, really appreciate your effort to join this meeting this afternoon. And the idea is. I was distracted by the chat, but anyway, and let's say just a few words. So this smart grid evaluation tool has been prepared as an ISGAN Annex 3 activity. The Annex 3 is the working group that is working on we started working on cost benefit analysis for smart grid, and we also enlarged our focus to not only to cost benefit but to decision making applied to smart grids. And particularly we worked in the last years on multi-criteria tools, since we have analyzed the cost benefit assessment, and we found several gaps in the application to smart grids. And so we decided that a good way to manage the project appraisal and in the smart grid field is to match multi-criteria with the cost benefit. Then we decided to develop a software tool, and the software tool is now on the web. It could be used by everyone after a registration phase. And the reason why I decided to offer this webinar is to show the tool, to invite people to use the tool, to make comments, to suggest change and improvements. And the idea is to at the end of this process to have a better quality cost benefit and multi-criteria software available for everyone. And nowadays in Annex 3, we are starting a new research activities that is on the application of the project assessment in the field of smart grid, particularly applied to smart grid. In many countries in Europe, but in the USA and many other countries in the world, in India and China, it is clear that if we want to make smart grid a reality in distribution systems, it is really necessary to make the smart grid a real part of the planning process. And so we need to include in our development plans the potentialities offered by smart grids. But this is not that easy, because in many cases we have to compare traditional actions like building a new line, adding a new transformer, to new ways to that could be offered by several players, customers, prosumers, and so on. And so it's really the time to have new tools to make fair and an objective comparison of different design options. And so this is something that we are going to start in the next months, and it's really up to date, I think. And so this is about the future of Annex 3. And regarding this webinar, you can see the outline. And after this brief introduction, I will leave the floor to Matteo, that is one of the author of the software, and so it's he's the best person to present with greater detail how the software works. So you can see that we have just few slides regarding the tool and the need of merging multi-criteria analysis with the cost benefit. And then there will be a presentation on the Smart Grid Evaluation Toolkit and the approach we have followed and applied. And then we got in detail on how to use the tool. So how to create a new assessment activity, how to create the structure of assessment criteria, how to define the criteria, how to weight the custom criteria, and then how to weigh the criteria and define alternatives, and finally how to read the results. And then we will have some concluding remarks. So this is what we are going to do for this afternoon. Again, thank you everyone for attending the webinar. I hope that it could be a little bit useful for your professional life. If not, I apologize for that. But believe us, we really try to do our best to make this afternoon as much profitable as possible. And Matteo, I think that now is time to go directly in the presentation of the toolkit, so the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you, Professor. And I will give you a brief introduction on the motivation that of the activity that NMXC made on the analysis for the Smart Grid Initiative. So we can go to the next slide. And Smart Grid Initiative are peculiar because are different from other the old planning activities, because since novel features and the service that will be enabled we produce relevant social economic impact, we have noticed that the traditional approaches for project assessment based on your economic evaluation are not so reliable. In particular, we have the Smart Grid Initiative have a wide range impacts and indirect and side effects, and most of these impacts are intangible because they affect not only the monetary sphere. And so since Smart Grid Initiative are something new in the power system scenario, we have a lack of data and data uncertainty. So the implication of these impact characteristics are related to the fact that not only monetary impacts are of interest, but we have also to identify the impact on society at large, on environment, and so in general the externalities. Since this wide range of impacts is difficult to identify the right impact allocation, quantifiably impacts is not possible, so it's not possible to give to them a monetary value that is reliable. And another problem is the fact that the strategy decision making is under uncertainty, since because the horizon of the the horizon of the planning will be okay. I see that you cannot hear very well.
Yeah, it's related to the Matteo. It's related to the fact that you're calling from a phone, so the sound quality is less good than direct connection through the web. But I'm afraid for today we will have to we have to live with it. So please go ahead. You can resume.
Yes, maybe I'll try to speak closer to the microphone.
Okay. And okay. I hope that the situation now, that mine, you can hear me well, better. And
Sounds better.
Okay. So, and by concluding this introduction, I can say that smart grid planning calls for effective tools in order to address these complex decision making problems. So, we should go to the next slide, and in which we present a combined approach for the evaluation of smart grid projects. This combined approach is based on the cost-benefit analysis and the multi-critic analysis, because in the research activity made within Annex 3, we saw that these two tools are complementary, and we can use the CBA for a monetary evaluation and the multi-critic analysis, the MCA, for a non-monetary evaluation. And the combined approach is useful for relieve the lacks of the respective of each tool, and also emphasize the strength of each tool, since cost benefit analysis is rigorous and rational, is well formalized, is widely acknowledged, and it is easy to communicate the results of the cost benefit analysis, while multi-critic analysis is flexible. It does not require the monetization of all impacts, and it's possible to assess multiple conflicting criteria and assures the participation of the stakeholders. By merging these two tools, we are not going to lose anything, because we are keeping the strength of both assessment tools. So we can go next, the next slide. And in the past, we already had a webinar here hosted by the NSA, and in which we presented the problem of decision making in the smart grid context, and we provide the theoretical background about the assessment methodologies, and also we highlight the standard weakness of current practice for project assessment. The webinar is available and at the link that is on this slide. In the ongoing webinar, we are going to present the results of these analysis, of the research, but in terms of tools. So we learn from our research activity what is needed by the smart grid context. And so we propose, we develop the EGAN Smart Grid Evaluation Toolkit in order to fill the gaps that we found in the context of smart grid assessment. So we can go next, and now I will present the tool. This is on the left. You can see the landing page of this tool that actually is a decision support tool for evaluating smart grid projects that actually combines the cost-benefit analysis and the multi-critic analysis, and allows an output-based assessment of a smart grid initiative based on an automated procedure. And this procedure allows to consider monetary and non-monetary impacts, and also to include the stakeholders' point of view in the analysis. The objective of this tool is to provide a reliable support for orienting the investments and also the regulatory policies on smart grids. We can go next. And this tool is already in use within the EaseGAN environment. And this tool has been designed for making high level and the assessment of high level and strategic initiative, and also the assessment of pilot and demo projects. We already have users from 11 countries, and the tool is mostly used for the assessment of active distribution network planning, which includes energy storage system. Also, it's used for the assessment of activities that concern the installation of storage for increasing the self-consumption of houses equipped with PV plants, and also is used for evaluating the strategies for the storage management in the context in which the storage is shared among users and also the system operator. And also has been used for the analysis of smart grid deployment alternatives, and also for assessing strategic roadmaps for developing smart grid. Then we can go next, and in this slide is given an overview of the assessment approach. The main goal of the tool is to identify the best smart grid option. And the evaluation is based on three different assessments, each one on a different area. We have the economic assessment, we have the assessment based on the smart grid deployment merit, and also we have the assessment of the externalities. By composing these three assessments, we achieve an overall evaluation of the alternatives. Is worth to highlight that the assessment is based on international guidelines. For example, in this picture you can see an overview of the structure of the criteria that are used for the evaluation. It's called hierarchy. And we have three independent branches. We have the CBA branch, in which the outcome, the result of the cost-benefit analysis of the project is considered. And then we have the smart grid branch, which is based on the guidelines developed by the European Joint Research the Joint Resident Center, which proposed a list of policy criteria and the related key performance indicators that are useful to assess which is the deployment merit in terms of smart grid deployment of the alternative. The third branch is concerns the evaluation of the project in terms of externalities. We can go next, and okay, the software is based on mainly three elements that have to be provided as input for making the evaluation. We have since we have to make a decision, we have to define the criteria hierarchy that is used for evaluate the strengths and weaknesses of each alternative. And each criteria has his relevance for the decision-making problem. So we have also to provide the weight of the criteria. In this slide, it's written that this input is optional, because also our software is able to make an automatic evaluation in which the weight of criteria are defined according to the characteristics of the alternatives. The third, but not less important input for the software is the performance matrix, that is a table which contains the value of the attributes of the alternatives defined with respect to each criterion. So the software basically analyzes this performance matrix and develop as I put a ranking of the alternative. And according to this ranking, the decision maker can understand which could be the best alternative to be implemented. And also other output of the software are the model of the multi-criteria model of the problem that has been defined as input and a stability analysis of the results. We can go next and okay. How to request an account for the Hidden tool? It's necessary to request an invitation code at the email address that is written in this slide, and then you will receive an email with your personal invitation code. Then you can log in the Smart Grid Eval website with the credential provided in the received email, and then by clicking the sign up button, filling the gaps with your information like name and surname, you can sign up. And at this point, your registration is completed and you can start using the software. I can show now in the next slide where to put your credentials in this basic, how to put your credentials in the landing page. And once that you insert your credentials, you will access in the user dashboard, in which on the top, we have this box that is the planning activity management box, in which the user can load an existing planning activity which he already created, and in the bottom section you can start a new appraisal by creating a new planning activity. We can go next and what is a planning activity for the terminology of the software? Since each strategic planning activity requires to make the right choice that basically is identify the best planning alternative available in the set, we define a planning activity the container of the decision making problem. Within a planning activity is formed by the evaluation criteria, the structure of these criteria, the weight that are provided for these criteria, and the planning activities that are defined in terms of attributes that then compose the performance matrix. So, different planning activity represent different decision-making problems. Okay. So for making the appraisal of a planning activity, the software requires to select, in this slide I will give an overview of what I will present next in the tutorial. So for making an appraisal of the planning activity, we need to select which of the three branches to be included in the assessment. Then it's necessary to define the criteria which compose each branch and to define the alternatives in terms of attributes with respect to all the criteria. Once that alternative is defined, we need to load the performance matrix of the alternatives and select the weighting algorithm or define the weight of the evaluation criteria by hand, by according to the stakeholder perspective, if available. Then the software requires to save the structure of the planning activity, and then the evaluation can be made, and the analyst can analyze the obtained results. So, we can go next because I already presented the fact that on the top you can load an existing planning activity, while on the bottom you can create a new planning activity from scratch. In particular, you can select the new planning activity tab, then you have to type the name of your planning activity in the box. And you can also choose if use an empty template, so starting really from scratch, or using a template. For example, we have already implemented a template that allows to evaluate the storage project. Then, by clicking on the create button, you can start your appraisal. And we can go next. We have also the possibility to clone the planning activity that already exists by using the tab on the right side in the bottom section. So we can go next. This is the planning activity overview page. That is the main page for starting the evaluation. The graphical user interface is made for guiding the user in the evaluation process. So there is no required any specific expertise on multi-criteria analysis for using the software. And the evaluation is based only on output-based data on the project that have been obtained from previous analysis. And also the information about the stakeholder view on the decision making problem could be required at least for creating the criteria structure. In this page, the user can select or define the evaluation criteria, define the number of planning alternatives, check the process, the progress of the appraisal process, and save the structure, watch the criteria tree that model the decision making problem, and see the results. So we can go next. And in particular, on the left panel, on the top, is required to write a few lines that describe your planning activity and to provide tags in order to better identify the topic of your planning activity. Then we have three checkboxes in which that could be selected for enable one of all the three branches that has to be involved in the evaluation process. Then the number of design options of the alternatives has to be defined, and then the last section is used for choosing the weighting method that will be used in the evaluation process. We can go next for analyzing the right panel, in which on the top we have a link for downloading the planning activity that has been built in the software. Then we have in the alt section three links. One is allows the user to download the template that actually are the spreadsheet files for defining the performance matrix and also the also for defining the criteria weights. And also we have spreadsheets used for making simplified cost benefit analysis. The second link is the help page for the criteria palette, and the third link is useful for define custom criteria, because this software the software has a predefined list of criteria, but the user can modify and create its own criteria according to the requirements of its evaluation process. Then on the bottom we have the to-do list, which allows the user to check it gives an overview on what is done and what is missing in the appraisal process of the planning activity that is going on. Okay, we can go next. And okay, this is an overview of the four buttons that we have on the bottom or section of the planning activity page. And so the first button structure is useful for saving the criteria tree. and it has to be placed on the criteria three is defined and before the data provision. Then the show three button allows the user to show the diagram of the defined criteria three. The third button, eval current PA, is the key button for obtaining the results of the evaluation process. And the last button on the right, the red button, clears everything. So be careful by clicking this button. Okay, we can go next. And now I will show you how to create a pending activity. So in the pending activity overview page, the user has to check the checkbox of the criteria branch that he wants to include in the planning activity assessment. So each checkbox enables the corresponding sub-branch. One, two, or three checkboxes can be selected. There is no any mandatory suggestion on that. So we can go next, and in particular, we focus on the economic branch. So by selecting the economic criteria checkbox, we enable the three checkboxes that are for the sub-criteria that the user can include in the economic branch. We have the net present value, the internal rate of return, the cost-benefit ratio, that are the most important indicators that are used for describing the results of a cost-benefit analysis. Also, in this case, one or more sub-criteria can be selected. We can go next for focusing on the SmartGrid branch. Also, checking the checkbox of this area, we enable the branch. And in the drop-down menu, the user can select the SmartGrid criteria he wants to include in the assessment. For example, in these default criteria are the ones defined by the JRC. And we can go next. And by, for example, in this, we select the network capacity criteria. And we have four different KPIs that are related to the network capacity. And so the user has to select one of these KPI that he wants to include in the assessment, and then press the help button. And the criteria list that is on the top of this drop-down menu will be updated. For example, we already select the operational flexibility KPI that is linked to the network connectivity criterion. Okay, we can go next. And for building the externality branch, the process is almost the same. We have to select the checkbox externality criteria, and in the drop-down menu, we can select the externality criteria we want to include in the evaluation. And we can go next, on the next slide. And also in this case, there are several KPIs that are linked to the criterion. And by clicking at the list of externality criteria will be updated, and this criteria will be used for the evaluation of the project. We can go next. I will give you an overview on the weight algorithm. The software has different weighting algorithms, but we can define three different groups. The manual weight algorithm is based on qualitative weighting of the criteria. In fact, the criteria weights are determined on the basis of the subjective preferences expressed by the stakeholder of the decision maker. So, is the decision maker that has to say to the software that, for example, the criteria A is two times more important than the criterion B. Why? We have the entropy standard and linear point weighting method that are synthetic weighting method. They do not require any input from the user, but the weights are evaluated according only on the data available for the alternative. The use of this weighting method is recommended when the alternative have remarkable differences in performances and a clear point of the stakeholder is not available. Then we have the hybrid weighting method that mix the manual and the synthetic weight method that that I described. And details on the algorithm are provided in the guide of the software. But in particular, I want to focus on the synthetic methodologies. The entropy weights are based on the principle of the theory of information. So it means that if an attribute carries little information, then it means that it has little relevance for the decision-making problem. So if the alternatives have small differences in the value of an attribute, then the related weight will have a small value. A similar concept is used for the standard weighting method. The standard weights are based on the statistical variance. So it considers the dispersion of the attribute's numerical value of the alternative. The greater the variance of a given attribute, the greater is the relevance that the relative criterion has for discriminating the alternative. So the greater will be the weight. The ideal point weighting method is a methodology based on a optimization model, which builds a virtual ideal best alternative, and the weights are obtained by optimizing the differences between each alternative and the virtual one. In this way, the overall score of the reality alternative, which is close to the virtual one, is emphasized. Okay, we can go next. And like the hybrid methodologies mix the manual and the synthetic weights. And we have three different strategies for make the aggregation. We have the aggregation by product, in which the weights, synthetic and subjective weights, are combined according to product relation, or we can aggregate these weights by using a linear combination or also using exponential relationship between the two weight set. And the aggregation by product and by linear combination require to define a parameter that gives the relevance that exists between the synthetic and the subjective weight. Okay, we can go next. Okay, once the structure is completely built, we have to save the structure. We can go next. And this is the image of the tree of criteria that depicts the criteria structure. This trio criteria is interactive and responsive, and the user can have an overview of the whole hierarchy that he built and inspect the specific sub branches. Okay, we can go next. Previously I said that the user can define its own criterion. And so by clicking on the main dashboard, on the Manage Custom Code Palette link, the user can enter in the Manage Custom Palette page. We can go next. We have two sections, one is for criteria and one is of KPA. The user has to start by defining the criteria. So we can go next, and by clicking Add, a dialog box appears in which the user can provide the criterion ID, a brief and a long description of the criterion, and also he has to define the branch to which the criterion belongs. And this is the result of the
of the user input. And once the criteria is defined, we have to we can define the KPI that are related to this criterion. So by clicking in the bottom section, we have the KPI dialog box in which the user has to define the KPI ID. The parent criterion to which this KPI is related to, brief along description, and the branch to which the KPI belongs. And also, it has to be defined if the KPI has to be maximized or minimized. It means that if a KPI has to be maximized, if the alternative is better with a negative value of the indicator, why it has to be minimized if the alternative is better when the value of the indicator is low. So pollution is a KPI that has to be minimized if you want to decrease pollution, while efficiency has to be maximized if you want to increase if you want to select an alternative that maximizes the efficiency. So during the evaluation process, that is not something that can be done in one step. We have this to-do list that remind us what is missing and what we still need to do and what we already made during the evaluation, during the construction of the evaluation process. And so we can go next. And I can show you how to weight the criteria. So in the main criteria weight page, we are redirected there by clicking on the branch weight in the to-do list that we show you. And so we have this light bar, and also by modifying the position of the scroll, we can modify the weight that are given to the three branches. In this particular example, we can see that the smart grid evaluation is more important than the evaluation of the externality impacts and the economic performances. And so we have the same procedure for giving the weight to the economic criteria that are in the economic branch. While the subjective weighting method for the externality branch is different, since we have a complex structure, so we can provide weight by giving a local priority vector or by using a pairwise comparison matrix. So we can go next, and the local priority vector, okay, we have on the right side in the picture an example of a branch structure in which we have two criteria and three KPIs that are related one to each other, and then the figures are the relative relevance among the criteria, between each criteria and each KPI. And so we have to provide a matrix that models that tree. We can go next. And we can go. Oh, okay, this is the weighting method. This is the weighting method for that use the matrices, the pairwise comparison matrices. We have a table in which the criteria are by rows and by lines, and we have to provide a score that models the relevance of criteria. For example, society is 9 times more relevant than environment, according to this example. So by completing these matrices and by clicking submit, the software will evaluate the criteria weight of your planning activity. So Now I can show you how the alternatives are defined. We need to download the template from the link, and we have a spreadsheet that has three pages. In general, the economic page, the smart grid page, and the externality page. We have by rows, each row represents an alternative, while each column represents a criteria. For example, the economic, by observing the economic table, we have three alternatives, and the attribute that defines the alternative is the net present value. We have that each alternative has a different value of NPV. And by uploading this structure, we are defining the alternatives that are evaluated by the software. Okay, we can go next. And okay, this is the quantitative scoring of the alternative is actually what I present. So we have to load the performance matrix of the alternative that contains the value of the attribute according to each criterion. While we have also, we can go next, and we can also have a qualitative scoring. So if we don't have figures for the attributes of the alternative, because the criterion that we are evaluating is not something that we can quantify, the decision maker can define a qualitative assessment of the alternative by using a comparison matrix. Essentially, for example, we have that delta as we can see on the matrix, we have that alternative one is seven times better than the alternative two in terms of net present value. So the alternative one allows to achieve a higher economic performance, while the alternative one and the alternative three are on the same level. So they are indifferent. The stakeholder is indifferent among by watching these two alternatives, considering the economic performance evaluated by the net present value. So we have a drop-down menu, and we can select the value that we want to put. Okay, we can go next, and finally, once that we complete the to-do list, we can press the eval button, and we will be redirected to the result page. So we can go next. The result page is mainly composed by tables and charts. So the tables resume the rank of the alternatives. For example, we have five alternatives that are ranked according to the overall score. And we saw that the best alternative for the evaluation problem is the alternative five that achieves the highest overall score. We also have we can also have a chart of this information, and also we have the partial rankings. So for the economic, the smart grid, and externality branch, we have the particular rank. So it can happen that alternative the best alternative for the overall evaluation is not the best for the economic point of view, but or the other branches. We have also the chart that resumes the relevance that we have defined for the branch, for the weight. So we can go next, and we have the flat weight. This is an output of the software because it evaluates the global weight, the global priorities of the KPIs of the decision tree that has been defined. This is useful for understanding the results that have been obtained, and for also with different models of the same decision-making problem. We can go next. And The last parameter that we have is the indicator of ranking stability, and so it gives an overview of on the stability of the provided solution. So it represents the invariance of the best alternative of the final rank. So the stability is in terms of the is evaluated with respect to criteria weight. So the indicator considers the range of criteria weight which in which there is no change in the final result. The greater is the indicator value, the greater is the stability of the solution. And also, if we use synthetic weight, we have the overall ranking that is obtained by using the synthetic weight instead of the subjective one. And finally, in the next slide, we have also the flat weight, so the global priorities that correspond to the synthetic weight method. We can go next, and we can conclude that new assessment approach for considering the potential of smart grid technology and labor wage impacts are required, and a joint MCA CBA approach cannot class the weaknesses of both CBA and MCA by emphasizing their respective strengths. The MCA CBA assessment framework that is implementing the smart grid evaluation toolkit supports the decision makers in the process of assessing the impacts of different areas, assessing the monetary and intangible impacts, and also it reduces the data required for the assessment, since also a qualitative evaluation is possible, and also promotes the active participation of stakeholders by including their point of view in terms of structure of criteria and weight of criteria. Finally, the automated analysis of the smart grid evaluation toolkit allows to analyze large set of planning options. For example, we use for analyze a Pareto front made of thousands of alternatives that has been developed by a heuristic optimization model. We know that a Pareto front is actually difficult to analyze if it is large. And okay, I conclude with that, and thank you for your attention.